welcome to this video. In this video, let us understand JK flip-flop and its working. JK flip-flop is a type of flip-flop. It uses the inputs as J and K. And third input is the clock signal. Clock will be a continuous pulse we are going to apply for any sequential circuit. The output of this device is Q and Q bar, where Q is the output and Q bar is complementary to that. Let us understand the circuit. The circuit of JK flip-flop designed here using NAND gates. The part of the circuit here you can observe, this is an SR flip-flop. The JK flip-flop is designed using the circuit of SR flip-flop by connecting the feedback. So clock is represented as a leading edge clock here. Means the JK flip-flop is going to work at the positive edge of the clock signal. Let us look at the truth table of the JK flip-flop. Here you need to see the clock signal which is shown as the upside arrow mark. This indicates positive edge of the clock is applied. These values are coming as output for these inputs. For 0-0 input, we are going to get no change in the output of Q. Means it will be holding the same state as compared to the previous state. If the previous state output is 0, output Q will be 0 here also if the 0-0 input is given. When 1-0 input is given as from J and K at the positive edge of the clock, output Q will be 1. Means whatever the input in J, that will be coming as output. When J and K as 0-1 input is given at the positive edge of the clock, output Q changes to 0. And when 1-1 is the input from J and K at the positive edge of the clock, output will be toggles. Toggle in the sense, if the output is 0 in this clock cycle with inputs 1-1, the same inputs will be continued for the next clock cycle, the output Q becomes 1. This is what the toggle state means. If again 1 and 1 state continues as input, in the next positive edge of the clock comes, the output becomes 0. This toggle state will be the output in JK flip-flop when the input is 1-1. Now let us write the code for JK flip-flop using Verilog. Let us write the test bench also and let us simulate and look at the waveform. This is the code design for a JK flip-flop. Module JK_flip-flop is the module name I have given. I am declaring inputs and writing the input definition here. Input J, input K, input clock, input reset and output Q. Here I am not showing the Q bar output since it is just a complementary output. And register Q, always at positive edge of the clock. This circuit is working at the positive edge of the clock. That's why I am designing for a positive edge. If reset is 1, I have taken one more input here as reset. When reset is 1, output will be 0. Else means reset is 0. This case statement is going to work. Case of J, K. Within the flower braces, I have writing J and K means here it is a concatenation operator. It will concatenate the 1-bit 2 variables into 2-bit variable. That's why 2 tick B 0-0 means J is 0 and K is 0. Output Q will be same as Q. It is holding its state or the same state. When J is 0 and K is 1, Q will be 0. When J is 1 and K is 0, Q will be 1. When J and K are 1-1, it is toggle state. Means Q will be changed to not of Q. This is our design. So we need to write the test bench for that. In the test bench, I am giving the module name as TB_JK, register J, register K, register clock, register reset. And then initially, clock will be 0, always at always hash 5, means every 5 time units, clock will be changing its value. So here I am defining the clock pulse. And then I am instantiating our design block, JK_FF, and I am mapping the ports. Here I am giving the values for reset as well as J and K. Initially reset is 1 and then reset becomes 0 after 10 time units. And then I have given all the 4 different cases of J and K values here. Now let us run this code and let us check the waveform. This is what the output waveform of the JK flip-flop. This is the clock signal. You can observe for every 5 time minutes the clock is changing its values. As a pulse it is continuously generated, and initially reset is 1 here. Remember, this flip flop is going to work for the positive edge, so we need to look at the output at positive edge of the clock. When positive edge of the clock comes, if the reset is 1, output Q will be 0. Until we are resetting that clock's output Q, the output Q will be unknown state here. So from positive edge onwards, because of reset is 1, output will be 0. And here you can see the one more case, reset becomes 0 here in the negative edge of the clock. If negative edge of the clock inputs any of the input changes, output will not change. Then come to the next positive edge of the clock. Here J is 1 and K is 0 and Q becomes 1. Because of J is 1, Q is 1 here since reset is 0. Again in the next positive edge of the clock, J becomes 0 and K is also 0. It is holding its same state. You can observe here in the negative edge of the clock, even if J changes, the output is not changing. And in the next state, it is reading J as 0 and K as 0 and Q is holding its state. In the two clock cycles, if you observe the waveform, Q will be 1 here also. Even after J and K change to 0, 0, it is holding its state. This is what Q is same as Q when J and K are 0, 0. In the next positive edge of the clock, values are same. We need to go for the next positive edge of the clock where J is 0 and K is 1. You can observe Q changed to 0 here. In the next positive edge of the clock, the values are same. In the next positive edge, J and K becomes 1, 1. When J and K are 1, 1, Q toggles. Toggles means if the previous state is 0, now it is changed to 1. If the same values of input continues as 1, 1, J and K, output Q will be changed to 0 here. Again in the next clock cycle, if J and K are 1, 1, output will be changed to 1. Again in the next clock cycle with the same inputs, output will be changed to 0. And you can observe here in the truth table, the first case is no change, and for 1, 1, it is going to toggle its state.